why Alabama is relevant, because of the coach.
And, oh, Nick Saban's a fantastic coach.
But I do like Jalen Hurts.
Yeah, Jalen Hurts is a good college quarterback.
But going back to the Peach Bowl, can I ask you a question?
Yeah,
would
sure.
you actually consider this an upset?
Yes.
Really? Because
UCF was the lower seed, was the underdog.
I guess, but they were going for the undefeated season, which they achieved, so congratulations to them. But I don't know. I thought it was a great game altogether. I think UCF had a ton to play for, and they came through. It was a good game to watch, but... You know, again, I was wrong. I picked with the SEC. I thought Auburn had it in the bag, but...
Hey, I was 0-2 at the CFP games. I picked Clemson and Oklahoma.
Oh, okay, gotcha. But, like, in terms of, like, the bowls that already happened, I remember I picked USC, I picked Penn State, I picked Auburn in this one. But it was just a great game to watch altogether. It really was.
It really was. I was really happy for Scott Frost and UCF to cap off that perfect season. And I really like Scott Frost. I think Nebraska got a steal with hiring him as a head coach.
I think so, too, yeah.
So, in the Citrus Bowl, Eric, your Notre Dame Fighting Irish... beat number 17 LSU by a score of 21-17. What did you think of the game, my friend?
I was getting nervous in the fourth quarter. But the final 2 minutes, I had a...
You could breathe finally.
Again, a lot of these games, with the exception of probably Alabama-Clemson, were great games to watch. It all came down to the wire, in my opinion.
They really were.
The Rose Bowl was better. But
Rose Bowl was amazing.
But again, Notre Dame, just I don't think they're that great. But again, they proved me wrong again. It just seems to me that this was a huge turnaround since last year. They were so bad this year, and they come back this year, and they're playing in the Citrus Bowl, and they just turn. Brian Kelly, I like him as a head coach. I don't know what the future holds for him. I think he's going to stay at Notre Dame because a lot of these head coaching hires are coming out of the blue.
I've heard his name mentioned.
So have I.
For an NFL head coaching
job. So have I. But here's the thing. I don't think he's going to leave because he turned Notre Dame football around.
He really did. Who was the coach before him?
Oh, God.
I can't remember. Was it Charlie Weiss? Is that who it was?
It might be. Let me check.
Oh, my goodness gracious. So, in an incredibly epic Rose Bowl, oh, my God, this is the best Rose Bowl in recent memory, let me tell you.
This is the best bowl game, period.
I would agree with that. Number 3, Georgia, beat number 2, Oklahoma, by a score of 54-48. What were your thoughts on the game, Joe?
Yeah, I've been a little bit quiet. You know, college football is not exactly my forte, but
watch this game.
I did watch it because Baker Mayfield definitely attracts a lot of attention, as you know. And, you know, when it gets into the final couple of games, I'm really interested to see, you know, how the quarterbacks are going to, you know, end their season and what impacts their stock in the draft and whatnot. So I always pay attention towards the end of it. And this was an insanely entertaining game, back and forth. And, you know, Georgia put on an incredible show and made the comeback. Interesting stat here. This is the first time Georgia's going back to the national championship since 1983, and it also marks the largest comeback in Rose Bowl history and just the third double-digit comeback.
Was Herschel Walker there in 83? Was he one of their guys? Someone check me.
I want to say yes, but I will double check. Again, with the Rose Bowl, trading scores left and right.
That was an incredible bowl game. Thank God I made it back in time from the Winter Classic to see that.
You know, in terms of like being relatively sick yesterday at my girlfriend's house, she was like, oh my God, like what do you need? I'm like, I don't know, like, what time is it? Put on Oklahoma, you know.
Oklahoma,
Georgia.
Eric, like, who was the head coach before Brian Kelly?
Charlie Weiss.
Hey, yay me! Oh, I'm better than everyone. Yes, I am. And look up if Herschel Walker was there for the last time Georgia made. Wait a minute, that was the Sugar Bowl. That was the 83 Sugar Bowl. That was, because Vince Dooley was the head coach.
So, yeah, he was there.
Yeah, we were just talking about that. Hello! Holy moly! Wow.
Good morning.
Wake up, Jacob.
Good morning.
Gee whiz. Well, you know what? It all comes together in the end.
Perfect.
Everything comes together. You know what? I want to talk about Baker Mayfield for a second. If the draft were tomorrow, he's the second best quarterback available.
Behind
Josh Rosen. And I could really see Mayfield going in the top five.
I was going to say a guaranteed top 10. Top five, I wouldn't say it's a reach either. I mean, he played a really, really good game yesterday. I think Georgia, like, absorbed Oklahoma's best shot that they were able to throw at them. And, you know, going to double OT was crazy. And you mentioned...
By the way, I love college football overtime. I think the NFL should have it.
Right, and, you know... his name, From Georgia.
Georgia, yep.
Yeah, I think he played a really good game, but also the running backs definitely bailed him out. They ran for over 300 yards. They were going off yesterday.
Kid's also 19 years old.
A freshman, right?
Yeah, he's a freshman. It's unbelievable. But I just want to ask you something. Before the Rose Bowl, where would you rank Baker Mayfield in terms of the draft if it happened? Would you say first round?
I think he's still going in the first round.
Honestly, I'd have probably put him low first round to high second round.
What about after the Rose Bowl?
After the Rose Bowl, he's top five, in my opinion. And he played an excellent game. It's not his fault that Oklahoma lost. For goodness sake, they gave up 54 points.
He does have a double negative, though, which teams find very appealing and very disappealing. It's his very fiery personality.
You know what, though?
He has the flair.
I love that.
I was just about to say, he has attitude. He has moxie. I love it. It's not like he's Johnny Manziel and hanging out late at night.
A lot of people are comparing him to Johnny Manziel.
Yeah. No,
I can't see
it's
it.
Not
I
a fair
can't
comparison.
See it.
It's not a fair comparison. The worst thing Baker Mayfield did was grab his crotch and glow to Kansas fans.
Yeah.
That's something I want my quarterback to do.
Stick to basketball.
I want my quarterback to have an edge. I want my quarterback to tick people off and to tell people to go do something themselves.
Yeah, you know, I saw... when they won against, I think, Ohio State in September, and he went and took the Oklahoma
flag
and planted it in the middle of the field. I love that. I mean,
if you're an OSU fan, you hate that. But if you're a college football fan, you love it. I love Baker Mayfield. I'm buying Mayfield stock.
I'm with you.
And you should listen to me when it comes to buying quarterback stock. Because if we really traded football players like we do stocks on the New York Stock Exchange, I would be a very wealthy man in terms of Blake Bortles.
You think so?
Of course I would. A 10-win Jaguar team, the 3-seed in the AFC? Come on, of course I'd make a return on that investment. I was buying his stock before the season started.
Yes, you were, that's
when
true.
When there were rumors he was going to be benched for Chad Henne, of course I'd make...
That was ridiculous
of
at the time.
Of course I'd make
a
profit.
God. But honestly, let's just see how Blake Bortles does in the playoffs. I think he's going to be fine.
He will win. That is my prediction. The Jaguars will beat the Bills. And Joe Ritter, you have to be the happiest person on God's earth right now.
Can I just put this into perspective? The last time the Bills made the playoffs, who let the dogs out and Livin' La Vida Loca was number one? who let the dogs out was a very relevant song at the time.
I grew up with that song. I can't say anything bad about it.
No, I'm not saying anything bad about it. I grew up with it, too. I remember it a lot more. I remember Y2K like it was yesterday. Holy crap.
I don't.
It's been a while, though. And honestly, I'm happy for the Bills. I saw the video of them watching the Ravens lose or win so that they would get in the playoffs. And they were just going crazy.
I've never seen so many cheers for Andy Dalton in one place.
not even in Cincinnati or at TCU.
My aunt is a Bengals fan, since Boomer, actually.
Yeah.
And she does not like Dalton. She does not like him.
See, now I'm torn on Dalton.
He started the year terrible. He didn't. They had two home games.
They didn't score a
touchdown.
Yeah,
he did. He
did
make up for it.
Second half. I mean, if you're the Jets, you take him.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah, sure.
Andy Dalton or Ryan Tannehill?
Ooh. I'll take Dalton just because I don't know how Tannehill's going to rebound from the injury.
Fair. So you think like Tannehill's injury prone?
Not so much injury prone as much as it is I'm very scared of quarterbacks coming back from injury.
Yeah.
Not everyone's Tom Brady can miss a full season and come back and not miss a beat. You know, it's why I'm scared of Teddy Bridgewater, because he hasn't started a game in 2 years. I'm terrified to give him a big contract. Like, don't get me wrong. If push came to shove, I would do it. But in my opinion, there are better options. I'd rather have Case Keenum than Teddy Bridgewater.
I would agree with that. He's played like amazing this year.
Yeah, absolutely. So in the Sugar Bowl, number 4 Alabama beat number 1 Clemson by a score of 24-6. What did you think of the game?
This did not have the luster like I thought it would, honestly.
No.
I thought that the Rose Bowl took care of that. But I'm kind of shocked by how well Alabama just rolled through Clemson.
Yeah, absolutely. And give Nick Saban credit. He's the second best coach in college football in my eyes. I'm still taking Dabo Sweeney over him.
They're not wrong. I don't think so.
I mean, Alabama just... I don't know if it's as much... Actually, no. I'm going to be more definitive. Clemson played bad. That's why Alabama won. The reality is, I don't think Alabama's defense was that great.
Alabama capitalized on Clemson's mistakes. That's all it came down to.
Yeah, absolutely.
How about De'Ron Payne, that 300-pound lineman? He had that big interception, and then he caught a touchdown on the drive with the tippy toes in the end zone. I thought that was really cool to see. Yeah.
Almost Refrigerator Perry-like.
Yeah. Or Sheldon Richardson. He used to do that for the Jets.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He did. I forgot about that.
My nickname for him was the Freezer. I will always have a soft spot in my heart for him. So we got about 3 minutes left. I'm starting the bottom of the ninth early, but I have a reason for it. So just hang on. But in any event, time for the bottom of the ninth. Eric, we'll start with you.
All right, so there is a report that the New York Football Giants are interviewing Patriots offensive coordinator Josh McDaniels on Friday. But I will tell you this. There are also rumors about Pat Shurmur, the offensive coordinator of the Minnesota Vikings, interviewing for the Giants head coaching job as well. If it came down to McDaniels and Shurmur, telling you right now, I'm taking Shurmur.
Really?
Yep.
You were that impressed with him in Cleveland?
More so Minnesota.
Okay.
Minnesota.
Yeah, but some coaches are just good coordinators and bad head coaches.
Yeah, do you like the Belichick, you know, the, I'm forgetting the word.
The Belichick connection.
Yes, the Belichick connection.
Yeah, I know. I think McDaniels did all right in Denver. The reality is he just didn't have time to develop Tebow. He was fired midway through Tebow's rookie year.
Yeah, that was his problem. But you know what? He came to the Patriots, and again...
And Tebow, in a weird way, worked out for the Broncos. He won a playoff game for him.
Look, I would choose Peyton Manning over Tim Tebow any day of the week.
Honestly,
at that time, yeah.
Honestly, if I was Denver during that time, I think I'd have rolled with Tebow and not signed Peyton Manning.
I am very upset that they let go of Tebow that early. Honestly, I didn't think Tebow was given a fair shot.
He really wasn't. Joe?
Well, this bottom of the ninth goes out to Isaiah Thomas, who's making his return from an injury last year. He's going to be playing tonight against his former team, being the Boston Celtics. I like this guy a lot. I mean, him being 5'9 and being as successful as he's been in the NBA, of course, you know, the loss of his sister happened last year, so there's been a lot going on for him. And, of course, he never wanted to leave Boston, and I think he's going to be welcomed home with, you know, a lot of cheers and applause. So shout out to Isaiah Thomas, man. Hope he does well tonight.
All right. Sounds good. So, obviously, this is the new year, and this has been such an incredible year for me. I've had Beyond the Game for over a year now. I never thought I would host a sports talk show, and I'm so grateful to everyone. Brandon, I hope you're listening. I hope you know that I love you. I could never ask for anyone better to start the show with than you. You're an original. Dominic, you're the next Bernard McGurk. I hope to have you as my producer if I'm ever lucky enough to make it on WFAN. Eric, you're my rock. I could never do the show without you. You've stopped me from going absolutely ballistic. Joe, I've been fortunate enough to work with you for 3 months. You've progressed in such a far way. And to Eleanor, the true hockey maven, Chompy, unfortunately, we're not able to interact that much because there's just not a lot of hockey to talk about. But I hope you know that if I didn't burn my bridge with Stan Fischler correctly, if I may say so, I'd have written you a glowing letter of recommendation. I can never, ever pay all of you back enough for everything that you've done for me. It's meant that much to me. It really has. All right. Looks like we're about out of time here on Beyond the Game. For Eric Fischetti and Joe Ardita, I am Jacob Volk saying, this winter, I'm working out every day, throwing at a wall. I'm 11-0 against the wall.
Want more sports? We have more sports.
Check out all of the sports offered on the Voice of Nassau Community College.
From the Press Box, Monday mornings at 9.
The Home Stretch, Monday afternoons at 5.
Beyond the Game, Tuesday afternoons at 5 and Friday afternoons at 3.
And Sports Talk, Thursday evenings at 9.
We've got the sports you care about covered on the Voice of Nassau Community College.
90.3 WHPC.
WHPC HD, Garden City.
Available on the iHeartRadio app.
The opinions expressed on air are not necessarily those of WHPC, its management, or Nassau Community College.
Responsible opposing viewpoints will be considered by emailing them to whpc@ncc.edu or by mail to WHPC 1 Education Drive, Garden City, New York, 11530.
Thanks for listening to the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Take a look under your bed. Find stuff under there? What about jobs? No? Now try your basement. There's a pair of overalls that overall you're not so into anymore. A perfectly good laptop that hasn't sat in your lap in months. And even more stuff, but still no jobs? Well, you really have both. See, stuff.